In today's video, we are gonna be smoking this pork shoulder. Let's get this out of the package and let's start to trim it. The only knife action we're going to be getting today is scoring the fat cap. I like to make small cuts along the fat cap about 1 inch apart. We're gonna score this again perpendicular to our first cuts. This will help our fat to render while we are smoking and keep our pork butt moist. Now that we have our pork butt scored, I am gonna go ahead and season it up with the Killer Hogs, the barbecue rub. These rubs have salt in it. Any barbecue rub you buy at the store already has salt in it, so I have had really good luck just putting on barbecue rub. I used to do two seasonings, but now I'm just a one seasoning kind of guy. Keep it simple, make it easy. So let's go ahead and get to seasoning. There are three parts that you need to season on the pork butt. First, we have the meat side, then we have the four edges where the bone is, and we have the fat cap. I always start out by seasoning the meat side first. I apply a thick coat of my rub, and then I pat it in with my hands since today I'm not using a binder. Then I flip the pork butt onto the edges and apply seasoning and pat it in. I'm going to repeat this for all four sides. Lastly, I'm going to season the fat cap. Let this rub set in for a good 15 to 30 minutes before getting it onto the smoker. We are out here today at my Rectech 1250. We are going to be rolling overnight for a total of 12 hours on the extreme smoke mode. It runs at about 180 degrees, and today we are using the hickory blend from Pit Boss. It is a blend of hickory and oak pellets. Overnight, I'm not going to be doing any spritzes. We're going to wrap it in aluminum foil in the morning to finish it off. We're putting it on at about 9:30 p.m. at night, so 9:30 a.m. We're gonna go ahead and get this wrapped up, but for now, we're gonna open up our Rectech. We're gonna let this lay on here and build a beautiful bark overnight. I'll see you guys in the morning. Good morning, y'all. It is 12 hours later, and we have some great smoke on this pork butt, and we're temping right around 160 degrees, so this is the perfect time to wrap. I always like to double wrap my pork butts with heavy-duty, extra-large aluminum foil. I've actually torn the foil before and had a grease fire, so I don't play games. My smoker has a little table that extends out, so I like to wrap it right here. But if yours doesn't, you could bring out a little folding table, or you could do this step inside your house. We're gonna fold up this pork butt real nice and tight in our foil, and we're gonna get it back onto the smoker. At this point, we're gonna crank it up to 225 degrees. After a long 15 and a half hours, our pork butt is ready to come off. It is temping right around 204 degrees, and it feels like butter. This was a big one. It was close to a 10-pound pork butt. Normally, these will take me around 14, 15 hours when I do it this low. But guys, let me tell you what, this is gonna be amazing. We had it going 9 hours in the super smoke mode. It was about 3 hours at 200 degrees. We wrap it up at the 12-hour mark, let it go for about 3.5 hours in the wrap. We're gonna let this rest now for probably about 2 to 3 hours. I'm just gonna put it up in my oven. I wanna start to shred this when it gets down to 140 degrees. So we're gonna let this hang out. I'll see you guys when it's at 140 degrees.
This has to be one of the most tender and moist pork butts I have ever made. This pork butt falls apart at just the slightest little bit of pressure from my fingers, and my fingers are dripping wet from all this rendered fat. It definitely passes this bone test. It pulls right out with no meat left on it. And just because this is really hot, I'm gonna use this bone like a wild savage to shred this whole butt apart.
Welcome to my dinner table. We have a whole entire 9 to 10 pound pork butt shredded up. And the reason why I use the bone is because this was still pretty hot. I didn't let it cool down all the way because I have to get this video over with and go take a nap because I've eaten way too much food today. This has a great bark. This has a great smoke ring. I'm sure it has a lot of great flavor, but there's only one way to figure that out. And I'm gonna get a piece of some bark right there. That has some good rendered fat, has some good bark, has some good red color for that smoke. Let's go ahead and give this a try. The second that I bit into this pulled pork, my mouth just shot full of juices. This was smoked super low, super slow overnight in the extreme smoke setting on my Rectech. Did that for about 9 hours, and I switched over to 200 degrees until we wrapped it. Then I bumped it up to 225 degrees. I let it finish out. It was over 200 degrees when I pulled it off. I let it rest in my oven for several hours. It was still piping hot when I went to go shred it. I didn't let it go all the way down to 140 degrees. If you do this, you will, by all means, please everybody that comes to your house. I make this recipe recipe all the time when I'm having a big group of people come over. This is one of the easiest things to make. You really cannot mess it up. As you saw in the beginning, there's no trimming. I just score the fat. I dump a bunch of seasoning over it. I don't care what it looks like. I throw it in the smoker and then I go to sleep. It really does not get any easier than this. This freezes really easy as well. You could freeze this if you don't eat it all. Pull it out for leftovers in the future. Like you can make pulled pork nachos. You could do pulled pork potatoes, or you could throw it on some pizza. This really is a very versatile dish in that you can freeze it and use it for things in the future. Today I used the thermopen to check the temperature on this. If you guys want to buy one of those, it would help me out. I'll leave the link for that down in the description below along with the recipe for this video. Please like this video, share it with your friends, subscribe to the channel. Better yet, you could just go ahead and make this, then share it with your friends. If you want to see some other great stuff I have, you can check out this video right here. As always, I'll see you in the next pork butt.